Hey guys, so I'm back with another video, and it's just gonna be really relaxed because today I'm filming and it's Labor Day, and so I've been at the pool all day. That's what I've been doing all weekend, working. It's been raining. I've been doing school work, so this is gonna be this week's video. And I just wanted to give y'all some like good palettes. This is my palette collection, and this is everything that I try to rotate them, but it don't really happen because there's like five that I love to death. So we're just gonna jump in. Okay, the first palettes I want to tell you about is Morphe, and this was one of the first palettes I ever got, and it's the Morphe and Kathleen lines. And as y'all can see, that red tones and oranges and coppers, and there's just two green shades down here that I never touched. But I mean, this was a good palette. This is, you can't go wrong with Morphe. Then I have the 35OS. And as y'all can tell, it's just lots of coppers and very natural shades to wear on an everyday basis. Then I have the Morphe 35F. And this is a good staple palette for like the fall months when you want to go a little more smokier with your plums and everything. I love Morphe's colors, like this color right here. I'm gonna swatch it for y'all. Like, look at the pigmentation. It's affordable. I mean, the palettes are like $20, I wanna say. I mean, you can't beat it. And then my favorite palette of all time is the Jaclyn Hill palette. And this palette has definitely got lots of love to every shade. I even use the blues. Like, you can't beat it. It has every color you ever need in this palette. But it's sold out. But when it comes back in stock, y'all need to get it. Okay, that was it for Morphe. Now we're going to talk about Anastasia Beverly Hills. And I have two of their palettes. And the first one is the Modern Renaissance, the Subculture. And as y'all can tell, like, this palette was legit because there's lots of pan hit in this one palette. I use this palette like almost every day for any kind of look. If there's, I don't know if they still sell this, but if they do, you need to go and buy it right now. And then the palette that Madison hates, the Subculture, that I was so ready to love. As y'all can tell, this was from a swatch. If y'all see a dent, because the colors are just, like, you can even tell, like, I tried using this shade, and it got all into this shade. Like, I don't like it when a palette does that. Okay. Now we're going to talk about the first palette I ever bought. Actually, my mom bought it for me. So, thank you, Mom, for showing my makeup addiction. But it's this. I think this is everybody's first palette. But just take a look. I hit pan in almost every shade. And this one right here, like, there's not even, I just dropped one. As y'all can tell, this one has no color there at all whatsoever anymore. This is a good palette for anybody. Like, don't care what color you are, you need to go out and get this palette because it's perfect. Oh, I dropped two of them. Next is the one I dislike. It's the Smoky. And my brush is still in mine, but I've never used this. Like, there's never any desire to even pick this up. Which is sad because I paid $40 for it the day it came out. Now, the newest one is the Heat. And I don't ever really dig into this one much just because my Jaclyn Hill literally has all the colors I need. So, I mean, I should use it more than I do, but I don't. And then this was my other favorite one. I used to be obsessed with Urban Decay. And this is the rose gold one, the Urban Decay Naked 3. And the colors are really pretty, like, for my blonde hair, like, my skin tone. But, like, now that I know of better, like, formulas, this one's kind of hard and chunky. Like, this one right here. Like, you can see that when I put it on my finger, it's real chunky. Look, I'll show you next to this. Like, this one has flakes in it, and I don't like that for mine. Now I'm going to tell you about my one Tarte palette. This one has also been very loved. There's not a shade in this one anymore because I loved it so much. It also smells so good. And I'm really looking into getting the Tarte, the purple one. I don't know what it's called. But I don't know if I should. So y'all should leave me a comment down below if I should. Just because it's all mattes. And I don't really use mattes a lot. Now, we're going to talk about Too Faced. Last year, around this time, Too Faced came out with something so cute and so great. And I was like, oh my gosh, I have to have it. The chocolate chip. Okay, keep this in mind. They've already made one. This is the worst palette I've ever spent my money on. And I'm so mad about this because I had a Sephora gift card. And this was like at Christmas time. So I'm like, oh my gosh, yes, let me use my Sephora gift card to buy this. Never even used it because it's terrible. I swatched it and I was like, let me do a little swatch for you, just to show you. You see this black shimmer? I ain't even fully black. That's patchy. Do y'all see that compared to these? No. Look, we'll take another one. We'll take this shimmer color. Did y'all see that? Like, it's falling out and everything. This is worse than the subculture. Can't even see it. Just not a good palette. And I hate that I spent my money on it. If anybody would like to buy this from me, please let me know. You can have it. Just pay for shipping. Okay, now I'm going to tell y'all about something I got from TJ Maxx, and I'm really happy about this, even though I've never even used it. It's this palette. And this is the Too Faced Love Palette. And I got this little thing from TJ Maxx. Like, I saw this, and I was like, I ain't even going to use it, but I got to buy it. I have a problem. Then I'm going to tell you about the Sweet Peach palette. And me and my friend Elizabeth, we were in Greenville one day, and this is when this came out, and she's like, oh no, you don't need to spend your money on it. But I bought it anyway. And at first, I really hated it because the colors were so hard to work with. But now, it's kind of a love. I sort of love it. But it says the peach palette, but like, really, where's the peach colors at? Because I see none of these really even look peachy to me. Like, most of these are just pinks and purples. And there's a green. Who uses green on their eyes? I don't know. Now I'm going to tell y'all about another palette that I fell in love with. We were in Myrtle Beach when this came out. And I was like, oh my gosh, I have to order this because it looks gorgeous. Y'all, it's not. And I hate it. It's the Too Faced the Natural Love palette. It says natural for a reason, and I really should have like thought about that, but I didn't. And I don't use it because it's natural, and nothing about me screams natural, except for like me right now. I look very natural because I didn't put no makeup on today. Okay, so now I'm gonna tell, I think that's it for my high end ones. Now I'm gonna tell y'all about affordable makeup. Because I know we all on a budget out there. I am too. This is the Eyes, Lips, and Face by e.l.f. And this was really cool because on the bottom end, it's like all these pretty colors. I've never used this palette, but Bailey has. I use these in it, like the blushes and the bronzers. And I like this down the bottom half of it. The top half, not so much. But it's really smart how they did it. I will give them that. Now I have the balm. And these are great. Because I found these at Nordstrom Rack. These two. And you can't beat them. Like, look at that. I mean, this is an all matte palette. And I use it for like something like this. That has mostly shimmers where I need to add in. But like, you can't beat that right there. And I think I ended up paying like $5. Maybe 10, 15, I'm not really sure. And now we have the Balm Appetite. And I really love this one. It's so cute. Like, you just can't beat it. And then this flips down. And I love the names of the shades. Like this one says, there's mac and cheese. And I don't know how to say some of this. I'm going to tell you the stuff I do know how to say. There's crispy bacon. You get it? Like, that's such a pretty color. And then Tate or Tots. Like, it's just so cute. And I'm going to swatch it for y'all. I'll do it on the back of my hand. Look at the pigmentation. Some inexpensive palettes you just cannot beat. Like this one. This, look how tiny this is. Like, it's as big as my hand. I paid like $8 for it. And you can't beat it. Like, look at that. And this, they have like a bunch of these, y'all. And you need to go and buy them. Because when I get enough money, I'm going to buy every single one. Every single one. Because I love them. Look at that. That's crazy, y'all. Just so you know, if you're not into makeup, go buy this. And if you're on a budget, go buy it right now. Okay, now we're going to talk about BH Cosmetics. And I had a little girl, I don't really know who she is, but she commented under my picture the other day asking if I had the Carly Babel palette by BH Cosmetics. But I didn't. I have this palette. And I love XO. I watch her on YouTube. And this palette was great. I think I paid like $10 for this too. But, and like the pan sizes are really good. And I love this like burnt red color. Oh, you can't pick shades like that. Okay. Let's find somewhere to swatch. Look how pretty. And that palette literally had like all the shades you need. And then they have a really cool twist to this palette. I've never used it, but it has lipstick on the back. So, like, it's kind of like, and you can use it however you want to. Well, I think that's it for all of my makeup palettes. I hope Bailey has a few of them in her room. But we're not going to include them because she's asleep. And it's like 11 o'clock at night. So, make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel. And I'm sorry if I rambled on for a little too long. But thank you. Bye, guys.